LRTT is a growing organisation which aims to deliver teacher training in less economically developed countries. My name is Bex. I am currently a team leader for the Ghana project. This is our first project working with LRTT and Sabre Trust, and we are working with a group of primary teachers, building on the work that Sabre Trust have already done with the kindergarten teachers. We've got 20 UK teachers out here at the moment who are delivering teacher training to over 200 Ghanaian teachers.
My knowledge about the teaching in Ghana, what I would say is that it needs improvement.
Because of the large number of students in the class, sometimes marking and going around to check on all of them has become a very big problem.
Their parents don't buy all their books for them. So when learning, you see, some will be left behind.
Go to places they don't even have a classroom. They sit under trees.
In Ghana, we don't have much materials, so sometimes we find it very difficult giving them the children the chance to go about the daily activities that we have.
Within Ghanaian education, it's very clear that they don't have very much. They don't have the resources that we have in the UK.
The school we're in now, it only has electricity. You put a generator in there.
There are so many children in the classes here compared to it back in the UK.
The teachers aren't able to talk to each other, they don't share ideas.
I was speaking to a teacher today who's been teaching for 20 years and very, very rarely attends any training. I think it's so vital that these 4 days make a huge impact, not only to bring them new knowledge, but also to update any existing knowledge they might already have.
For the last 2 weeks, we have been planning and practicing and preparing different training sessions to do in a 4-day-long conference. My name is Emily Shores. I come from Chicago, Illinois, in the United States. Last week, we had our first week of conferences where I presented on behavior for learning and also story sharing, and I got a chance to work then with other teachers from Ghana and kind of coach them through some of the things we were using during the sessions, as well as training them in those two areas. And then the rest of the team has been going through different aspects of teaching that are important for the teachers to learn a little bit more about while I've been sitting and coaching with them.
I definitely feel like the training has been a success so far. The rapport with the teachers and us, I feel, has been really, really positive. And the relationships that we've building have helped us all learn from each other. They definitely are taking things on board, the Ghanaian teachers here, and also giving us so much to take back with us. I've learned so much, especially like attention grabbers and how to get your class engaged. I'm going to take so many of those strategies home with me, so it's not just a one-way thing.
The conferences were brilliant. I think it was really nice that we did the first conference and then had an opportunity to reflect upon it, to adapt some of the things and tweak some of the sessions to make them more appropriate and more relevant. And the second conference, I think everybody felt more confident and really felt like we succeeded in what we kind of came out here to try and do. And that was definitely reflected in the positivity of the teachers. In a really micro sense, you can see that with all the photos that people were taking and the selfies when we finished the conferences, and the fact that people wanted to share emails and exchange contact details. That's down to each individual fellow and the relationships and rapports they've built with their small groups that they've worked with.
The facilitator made a statement which to me is the key note. She said that if you don't grab the attention of your students, whatever you present to them will be meaningless. So I believe that what I've learned, what I'm taking home and what I'm going to implement is how I will be able to attract my students' attention before I deliver what I have for them. I have really enjoyed every bit of it.
I've learned a lot from this place, especially with the phonics. How to blend the sounds of the letters to form a word, teaching them the sounds. I've learned a lot.
The participants, you involve them in your lessons, and that makes the lesson very, very interesting.
Here you open up, you interact with us and other things. So you are superb. You're really fantastic.
I've learned a lot. It's been so fun. I'm happy, I'm excited to hear from other parts of the world what they do to train their children, to bring them up very nicely. It's fantastic.
My bones, it goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home.
I think it's a great opportunity for you to instill that knowledge, that passion that we have with other teachers and share that, but not only kind of doing that with them and passing the knowledge on, but you're kind of learning as well, not just from the local teachers, but from the teachers that you're working with in a group.
I'm now even more excited to go into the classroom, and I've learnt so much from both the Ghanaian teachers and from the English teachers.
You meet new people, it's really sociable, but you also can see the value in what you're doing here.
This experience has been, as cheesy as it sounds, life-changing. I've thoroughly enjoyed myself. I'm looking forward to taking everything I've learned back home with me and using it in my own classroom.
It's something that not only will change your perspective on the world and on teaching, but also change your life in some way, because you get to meet other people and make friends who are from a different place than you are.
Not only do you feel like you're making a real difference in a country that really needs it, you also get to make so many new friends and experience a whole new culture.
It's been one of the best experiences of my life.
I can't stop them, I can't stop the feeling. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, 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 dance. Ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. Yeah.